behalf of Ben Weider and the IFBB, I'd like to welcome you to the 1996 Olympia contest. Unfortunately, Ben Weider is ill this evening and he cannot be with us, but he sends his best to all the bodybuilding fans. One message from Ben Weider. He says he is this close to Olympic recognition. Maybe he'll get it this year. Enjoy the show. Thank you for coming.
Thank you. A lot of people don't understand how much time and effort it takes to get into contest shape. I mean, going in the gym is complete, and training for your own purposes or for your own peace of mind is completely different than going in the gym with a contest in mind. There's a lot more pressure that you put on yourself and that others put on you. It's a lot more time consuming to do something like that. But, you know, I just decided that wasn't where my heart was, and it's something that you really have to have the drive to do it right. Well, what I do is I design and work with a group of people that design primarily commercial kitchens for the Marriott Corporation. I think the one thing that is good about that is because we do something that's completely different than bodybuilding, it keeps you sane. I think it's important to have some kind of balance to have a more of a well-rounded life. I mean, I have friends of mine that are into weightlifting. I have a lot of friends that don't know anything about it. They just say, oh, good luck in your little contest. You know, they don't have a clue, but that's nice. I like it that way.
chick.
Yeah, yeah. We need a chick who's cool.
Yeah.
Let's have some action. Let's have some wiggling. I want some perfection.
1990, 1991, 1992, 1993, 1994, 1995. Tied with Corey Everson for the all-time record of 6 Ms. Olympia wins. Attempting to break it, the magnificent Linda Murray.
Captured her first Miss Olympia title.
Linda Murray is going for the seventh consecutive title to break the record. Good luck, Linda, from your friends here in the Motor City.
Oh, it's nice because I know that I still have longevity in the sport to attain other goals. This being one of the goals I'd like to attain is win the Miss Olympia, of course. So I've proven myself as Miss International, and now I've brought the best package possible to Chicago, and maybe there'll be a change this year, and hopefully I can attain my other goal. It's been very exciting for me, and it's been a real motivator as far as training and preparation for the show, because I know my friends and family are all going to be here, and it's coming back home. I've lived my entire life basically up till the last 2 years in Illinois, and this is just a really nice homecoming for me.
Chicago Bulls, welcoming back to Chicago, Illinois' very own, the one, the only, Kim Jezewski.
Before I used to think, what do the judges want, what they're looking for? But I always sort of have this picture in my mind of what I want to look like. Not just for competition, just in general training, of what I want to look like. And I'm quite sure I've surpassed that picture many times because the goalposts keep moving, you know, that picture keeps changing. And I think if you just, this game, you've just got to run your own race. You've got to draw your own lines and run your own race and just aim for what you are happy with, because you've got to live with that body for 365 days a year, and that's what I do.
just a baby in this business of love. I'm a mover, a shaker, like Mac and I. I can take your last dollar with the throw of the dice. I get the wind from heaven above. But I'm just a baby in this business of love.
I came into this show thinking that this was my first Miss Olympia, and I wanted to do the best that I ever that I could. I wanted to look my best, so I came in as being positive. I didn't look as, man, I can't beat Linda, or man, I can't beat Laura. I came into this show like I'm gonna look my best, and whatever the outcome comes, it comes. But and that's how I took it. I was always positive. I trained hard, and I never really had a, you know, doubted myself, you know, putting like, man, I can't do that. I always kept, you know, my confidence high and stayed happy as far as when I'm training and was getting ready for the show. So I always kept a positive attitude. And that's how you should always think. You should always think you're a winner, you know, whatever, regardless of whatever you're doing.
When you feel like hope is gone,
A lot of girls, you know, with time and training and all, a lot of girls have improved. And it makes for a better competition because you don't get the same three getting the calls and the others in the background. And even though there's 12 competitors, I remember a time when there was 30 girls competing, and really just five was incredible, or maybe top 10 was incredible. You have 12 girls today that could be Miss Olympia, so it's a different ball game. So you get a lot of calls against a lot of girls. And it's like I haven't got a clue how I'm doing. Doing the show today, it's like if I get, you know, I don't see myself winning the show today, but whatever place I get, I'm going to know it's because other people were better than me that day. Sometimes in the past I've thought that I deserved to win and everyone knew I was a clear winner and didn't get it. Those were different circumstances, but I think getting older and I'm enjoying it a lot more. So I come, you know, we got here early, we're backstage and we're all laughing and cracking up, and then you go and you got to do what you have to do on stage, but I'm enjoying the process a lot more.
Three-time Miss International champion, runner-up of the Miss Olympia, Laura Craval.
Want to be good bodybuilder, and when I start, a lot of people told me you crazy, you never win national championship, but I win and three time After them, I go to European Championship. They say, you're crazy. You never win because it is capitalist country. They win or you from Lithuania, you never win. But I win. After them, I go to World Championship. And they told, it is not Europe. It is World. You never win. But I win. After them, they shot a little. But when I go to Atlanta, they thought, oh, it is America, and nobody don't see at you, because you're Lithuanian. But I was surprised very much, because for sport, it's not the matter from what country to you. It is, you're American or you're Lithuanian. If you're good, you're good.
I think genetics and heart have a lot to do with it, perseverance also. Genetics alone will not get you to this level or any level. It's something that really comes from the heart, something that you really want to do, and you persevere through any obstacle in your way. And that is what makes you a national champion or an Olympic champion.
mother, 'cause I'm going
to the Dawn, playground for the new power generation. There are over 500 experiences to choose from. Here's a sample.
Did you enjoy that? Well, there's more.
So can we have back on stage contestant number one, Beatrix Gluck? Number two, Sue Myers. Number three, Melissa Coates. Number four, Linda Murray. Number five, Eva Zhukovova. Number six, Kim Krzyzewski. Number seven, Joanne Lee. Number eight, Vicky Gates. Number nine, Laura Cravel. Number 10, Natalia Murnikovina. Number 11, Nancy Lewis. And number 12, Andrella Blanchette.
And Jan will take a check for $1,500 and a certificate. And give it to competitor number two, Sue Myers. Sue Myers, 10th place. In 9th place, being presented a check of $2,000 by Dave Nelson of Pro Body Warehouse. And he will take the check and the certificate to competitor number 3, Melissa Coates. In 8th place, receiving a check of $2,500 and a certificate, being presented by Brian Brosfield of Optimum Nutrition. And he will take those awards and present it to competitor number 12, Andrella Blanchette. And in 7th place, receiving a check of $3,000 and a certificate being presented by Don Long of Vivren. And Don will take those awards and present it to competitor number 5, Eva Zhukovova. I would like to congratulate the ladies who finished 10th through 7, and please ask them to leave the stage. Feet together, please. Quarter turn to the right. Quarter turn to the right. Quarter turn to the right. Quarter turn facing front. Front double bicep. Side chest. Turn to the rear. One leg back, showing the calf. Double bicep. Side tricep. Go, Turn to the front, abdominal and thigh. Ladies, relax.
You're unbelievable. Singly lies, it's all mean you can ask us. Pushing down the medicine, bringing out your high stuff. Bigger the fun front. Pushing down the better view instead of bringing out the business to walk the world.
Okay, ladies, relax. Sixth place, a check of $3,500 being presented by Melanie Moss of Universal Nutrition. And a certificate being presented by D. Monroy from Giant Killer Activewear. And they will take those awards and present it to competitor number 11, Nancy Lewis. In fifth place, receiving a check of $5,000 being presented by John Salvetti of Strive Equipment. And of Delia Gutierrez of Jaguar Activewear. These awards will be presented to competitor number 8, Vicky Gates. Fourth place, a certificate and a check of $7,000 being presented by Jim Vallone of Global Nutrition. And he will take these awards too. Competitor number 9, Laura Craval. Third place, receiving a check of $10,000, a certificate, the bronze Miss Olympia medal, and the bronze Sandow medal being presented by Peter Parsons of American Bodybuilding Products, Tom Prophet of Hammer Strength, and Steve Ward of Champion Nutrition. And those three gentlemen will take those awards and present it to competitor number 10, Natalia Monacovini. In second place, receiving a check of $20,000, a certificate, a silver Miss Olympia medal, and a silver Sandow medal being presented by Sana Kay of Powerhouse, Sarah Barbro of Otomics, and Donald Fitcher of Epicure Cream. And they will take that award and present it to Linda Murray. And presenting a check of $50,000, the gold Miss Olympia medal, the gold Sandow medal will be Joe Weider and Rudy Panada to the new Miss Olympia, Kim Chavesky.
Congratulations again, and I know on Thursday at the press conference you made a special point of saying that you had a surprise for your hometown Chicago audience. Tell us a little bit about that.
Well, I know that the routine is extremely important and can be used to determine the winner of the show, so I called Ray Clay, the announcer for the Chicago Bulls, and asked him if he could do a good intro for my routine, and he was more than happy to oblige.
Chicago Bulls, welcoming back to Chicago, Illinois' very own